plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Hold tight, as they say, in the land of plumbing. Welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video. Today, we're going to look at pressurised heating systems. Now, we've looked at them before in the way of how they work, how they deal with their expansion and everything, but this video is actually a request from one of our followers on YouTube who said, look, I don't know how to drain down my pressurised system. I've got a little job that I need doing, and it'd be great if you could show me how to do it. Now, as we say, don't do this sort of thing if you don't know what you're doing. You do need to have a basic knowledge of plumbing if you're going to try and do this. But I'll give you a step-by-step guide on how to isolate and drain down a system. And then, you know, do whatever work you're going to do. Have a cup of tea. Scrub your cat's belly. I might even put a couple of questions in here. So anyway, let's have a look at how we actually isolate and drain down a pressurised heating system. And then do whatever you like. And then I'll show you how you fill it up again and then get it all back and working. Hold tight throughout the night.
Blah! You know, my father always told me the first thing you should do is isolate electrically the heating system. That's what we're gonna do now.
This switch here turns it off, alright? That's the heating system off. We don't want it coming on or anything like that while we're draining down. The last thing we want is the boiler lighting up or the pump coming on. It could burn the pump out, it could overheat the boiler and crack the sections. So the first thing you do is make sure that the heating system is switched off. But James, I hear you ask in your stupid voice. How does a pressurised heating system work? You know, I need a basic knowledge of them to know how to drain one down. Well, usually you've got your boiler, your pump, any valves. You can either have a three-port valve there or a couple of two-ports. On this system, we've got 2 two-port valves. Then you're going to have your coil going into your cylinder if you've got one, if not a combi system. Then also you're going to have your radiators. Blah, back to the boiler. Blah, back to the boiler. God, what a diagram. Beautiful. Now, some heating systems use a gravity feed in the loft to actually push water down via gravity from a tank up there with a ball valve in it down into the system. But nah, we don't have that on a pressurised system because we're ledges, aren't we? Yeah. Basically, we have a cold water main comes in, goes through a filling loop into what we call the manifold that's often at the bottom of the expansion vessel. So have a big expansion vessel like that. If you want to know the principle about how pressurised heating systems work, then watch our video on pressurised heating systems. I'll leave a link to that here. So you got that filling loop, braided hose. You can have a non-return valve there, a valve there. This braided hose is removable, so the system doesn't automatically or accidentally fill up off the cold water main, which could pressurise it, which could bulge radiators, which could cause your whole world to come falling down. There we go. That's the basic gist of how they work. The water heats up, expands into this expansion vessel. Like I've said already, go to our video on pressurised systems, then you'd know. Oh. So let's have a look at this system here. So here is the loft that we're looking at, and the particular part we're going to be taking notice of is that bit there. So here we are in the lion's den of possibly the worst pressurised heating system install I've ever seen. Right, so we've got our feed from the cold main here. That's this valve here, this boss valve. We've got our braided hose here that's also got a little valve in it that you can't see. But that's just a little black handle valve. Let's get around here and have a little look. Can you see that? There it is, little black valve there. Lovely. Now that braided hose comes up here and through this, which is a non-return valve, okay? That means that heating water can't push back down the mains if there's any problems like that. Next we have our little manifold, okay? All this is just a series of ports that allow water in and out of this particular part of the system. Now we've got our pressure gauge here, which is currently reading about half a bar, which is borderline okay. The system's cold at the moment, so when it heats up, I imagine it will come up to about 1 to 1.5 bar. At the top we've got our high pressure relief valve. Now this has a small spring in it, so if the pressure gets above 3.5 bar, which is all the way around here on there, that spring's going to lift up and it's going to get let water out of this pipe here, and that will go outside where it's terminated at a safe place. The next thing we have to look at is this part here. This is the expansion vessel. The water can expand down into this and be happy. And this side here is heating system pipe, okay? This feeds the heating system, alright? So, now, and now only, can we drain the heating system down. One thing I want to stress about what we've done, those two valves should be off anyway. You've just got to make sure they're off, okay? Don't turn them on again or anything like that. Make sure they're both off. They should not be left on ever, alright? But now I hear you say, what about draining the system out? Well, most heating systems, okay, let's say we've got a two-bed house, okay? Look at this, a two-floored house, right? We've got a radiator down here, radiator down here, radiator down here, and a radiator down here. Say the boiler's, I don't know, in and out house or something like that. Usually what we've got here, we'll have an airing cupboard up there, your boiler flow will go up into the airing cupboard, okay, and then it will get distributed around these rads
off to each radiator. They'll come down like that. Oh, lovely. And then they'll join up at the bottom and then go back to the boiler. Now, what you'd usually be looking for is you go downstairs and you try and find a little drain off where you can put your hose outside and let water gush all over next door's primroses or something like that. Now, that's great, you know. Sometimes that's brilliant. But, and like I'm going to show you in a minute, sometimes the systems are actually laid out in a completely stupid way. Which means, say we've got a system like this. It's brilliant. But there's a radiator in the hall that has two pipes that go down to it. A flow and a return, okay, and they go to that radiator and pipe that up. You could drain all these lot out here, but that radiator there is going to stay full of water because there's going to be its own little drain off on it, and that's got to go out there. So keep an eye out for that, all right? And we'll show you one of them in a minute because we do have those in this house. Let's go and find a drain off now, pop a hose on it and shove it outside and actually start draining the system down. One other thing I'd say is before you drain down the system, go round and turn all the radiator TRVs on fully, okay, so then they'll all drain out nicely.
In the words of Biff of Back to the Future, well, looky what we have here. This is a drain-off, this bit here. Okay, now, drain-offs do have a bit of a knack of having a bit of a leak sometimes. Nothing mental. All you have to do is just pop a towel down and make sure that it's okay. Now you get your hose, which has been in the van all night and is freezing cold. We're going to pop that on here. And that's a nice tight sort of fit on that spigot there, which means I won't have to put a Jubilee clip or anything around that. What I'm going to do now is take my hose outside and go, be free. Now we've got that outside, all we need to do is get a grip and undo this, and you should start to hear water coming out. If you don't hear any water coming out, then go on our video on how drain offs work. I'll leave a link to that on this video as well. Right, you should now go back upstairs to where your own cupboard is. Sort of the system pressure now is reading like nothing, hardly a thing, no bars whatsoever. So the system pressure there is not reading a lot. Come down here and have a look. Right, so first thing I do is, remember we've got the heating system power switched off, so go down to your two port valve and latch that in the open position and do the same on all two port valves. Any motorised valves you find, latch them in the open position, okay? They're not going to come alive because the heating system is switched off. Go to the highest point if you find anything like an air vent like this. Be a good idea just to open that now as well, and that'll allow air into this system so it doesn't put a vacuum and that'll go down. Right, and now we go to each radiator in the house. Now I pretty much go around the house. I always try to find if they've got a radiator that's high up like this one. Start on the top floor, the very highest radiator on the system. Get yourself your radiator key and open that up, and that'll allow that sucking water into the system now, okay? And that means the water level in this rad is slowly dropping down. And when it gets to about here, it'll be the height of this little radiator here. And then I'll be able to open this up and do that. Right, remember what I told you about sometimes having legs? Right, we've got a radiator here, as you can see behind this. Now, there's two pipes there. As you can see, two pipes down there. And they run up behind this television, then upstairs. That means that this radiator, once we've opened up all the rads upstairs and that, isn't going to drain down because it's on its own leg. So we should find that somewhere the guy who fitted this has put in a drain off. Now, there isn't one there. I can't see one down there. Aha! There's one just there. Which means you're going to have the joy of pulling out this whole television and then getting your hose on there and then trying to drain that radiator out. Only really do that if this is the radiator you actually want to work on. I mean, we've got another radiator here, okay? You might not want to work on this. This has got another leg on it. There's a drain off here. If you don't want to work on this radiator, don't bother draining it out, okay? That'll just stay full of water up to here, all right? So then, the system now is fully drained down. You've gone outside and you looked at your hose and the hose isn't running. The legs you worked on, you've drained down and everything's absolutely hunky-dory. Now you can change that TRV, whip that radiator out and put another one on, or do whatever pipe work you need to do on this pressurised heating system. So, you've done all that, okay? What do you do when you've finished doing all the work? How are you going to fill this lot back up again? Now, I'm going to ask you a little multiple choice question now. It's going to be like Blue Peter, but without the drugs. And what this is going to be is this. What do you do next? Do you A, close the drain off and close the radiator bleeds? Do you B, turn on the electricity to the heating system to get it running? Or do you C, go on Twitter and check your Twitter feed? Teachers, you can now pause it if you like. Get these kids to have a little think about it. The answer is A, go downstairs, go back to where you were, turn off your drain off, okay? Turn that off and take the hose off and take it outside, and then go around the house and shut all your bleeds on your radiators, okay? This is so important. If you don't do it, when you come to refill the system again, you're gonna have all these lovely little leaks everywhere that is just gonna annoy you and make
maybe a customer if you're working in their house. So let's go downstairs now and turn the drain off, and then let's shut all the bleeds as well.
I gotta turn this bleed off. I don't want no water coming out when I refill the system. Yeah.
Not the phone again. Can you please send me a quote for my bathroom, please? In a minute, son, we're filming.
Right, we go back round all our radiators. I mean, this is the one I showed you earlier. Turn that off. Turn that off, make sure that's not doing anything anymore. Go around all the rads and do that. Don't forget any radiators.
Right, so now you've closed your drain offs and you've shut all your air vents and everything on the rads and you're ready to fill up. The best thing you can do is top it up so it goes to one bar, go and vent a radiator when no more water comes out, come back here, have a look at that gauge, put that back up to one bar and then do it and so forth until you've done all the radiators. When the system's then full up, we'll repressurise it. I'm going to put this back to half a bar because this system's worked really well at that pressure when it's cold. But most of you are going to put your system back up to one bar, which is the cold working pressure for most heating systems. I'll shut down our bleed here because we don't want water coming out of there. And then I'm going to open my valve here. And I'm also going to open my valve there. And I'm going to pressurise the system to one bar. While this is happening, all right, it's the time that you want to go and check the work you've done, all right? Because you never know. I mean, this has never happened to me. I never get any leaks, but you never know. You might have a leak. So keep an eye on all that sort of thing. So we're going to pressurise the system now, and you should be able to see in a few minutes, the system pressure here should start to rise. Take special note here, this beast is rising up. We're going to get that so it comes up to one bar. First place I'm going to vent is just here. Just going to let that vent now. And I'm also going to vent just here. And while you're venting down, you'll notice that the pressure up here is going to drop. Right, so that's going now. See, we've let some air out now, and that pressure's just dropped slightly. Now, what I'm going to do, because we've just dropped a little bit of pressure, I'm going to turn our water back on and repressurise that back up to one bar. Now you've actually got the airing cupboard vented of air, the next place I'd go to vent the radiators out would be downstairs. So the idea is you fill the heating system up from the bottom, and then you go upstairs and then you keep filling it up. Every time you do a radiator, pop back to your gauge here and make sure that it's still at one bar or at whatever pressure you want to pressurise it at cold. But never over one bar, never pressurise the system over cold above one bar. So anyway, I'm just going to pop a bit more in here because I've just done a radiator. And now I'm going to go around and vent all the radiators on this system. While I'm doing that, I'm going to leave you with a quick thing to think about, okay? You've got the system back on. We've unlatched both of our valves or whatever three-port valve or whatever control motorized valves we have. They're now unlatched and back into their normal positions. What should we do next? Now that we've drained this system down and we've got it all filled up again and we're pretty much ready to turn it on, what is the next thing we should do, okay? We have tested for leaks as well, all right? So that's done. So basically, you're filled up, there's no leaks, everything's brilliant. What is the next thing we should do? Should we A, turn the power on and get it all running? Should we B, inhibit the system with an inhibitor? Or should we C, ask the lady who we're working for a cup of tea? It's a trick question, this one, really, isn't it? I'm going to go and vent these rads. You can have a little think about it. See you in a sec. Now we'll go all round our radiators now and vent each radiator out. Right, so that one's done. Right, I'm back now, it's all vented, still at one bar. I might try it at one bar, we'll see. So the thing you should have done, the right answer was inhibit the system, okay? I'd say that was B, wouldn't it? But also, the answer's C. Because, I mean, if she hasn't made you a cup of tea yet and you've done all the work and that, then what's wrong with her or him, okay, you know? I'm not going to be sexist here, but there are just as many men than women who don't make tea for you when you go around their house. I don't know how, am I digging myself a hole here? Inhibit the system, okay? Then get everything turned on and running again. You're probably going to get quite a lot of air about, so you might have to do a little bit more venting. But every time you do any venting, just make sure you turn the system off, okay? So hopefully you now know how to drain down your pressurised heating system, how to safely fill it up to a safe level, and how to vent it all. And also then you also know the things you need to do to actually fully reinstate the system, and by that I mean inhibiting it. If you need any more help or you need any more information, visit our website at plumberparts.co.uk. You can follow us on Twitter and Facebook, and also you can subscribe to our videos. We do loads of stuff on Twitter. We're always retweeting some of the dreadful plumbing disasters that you guys come up against, and girls, on a daily basis. So, you know, give us a shout. We love to hear from you. And we'll see you in our next video, which is going to be an Ask the Plumber video. So if you've got any questions for us, ask them in the comments below, or ask them on any of our videos, or better still, tweet or Facebook us, and we'll try to cover those in our next Ask the Plumber video. Until then, have a lovely day, have a lovely week, and I hope they have a lovely weekend as well. I'll see you later. Hold tight.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.